Hey everybody, happy hump day and thanks for tuning in to Cocktails with Kirsten, Happy Hour Home Edition. I'm back. I've had a nice maternity leave. I've missed doing this, so I figured I'd jump back in the saddle. I'm still enjoying being home with our little baby until September 28th, and then I'll be hitting the streets. Back to work officially, so I'm excited about that as well. So thank y'all so much for joining me this evening. I know it's dinner time, but I want to just knock this out really quick, and then I think Sam and I are going to take, and Hayden too, are going to take a little walk, but I wanted to get this done before I forget. So this evening I am preparing the blackberry simple syrup as well as the basil salt for our blackberry basil smash cocktail. This is for the rim. The blackberry syrup is for our cocktail. So I'm just gonna get started. I'm not gonna take up a lot of y'all's time because I know time is precious, and Hayden is being entertained by daddy, and who knows when she's gonna go crazy. So that being said, let's start with the blackberry simple syrup. Super, super simple. All you need is 1 cup of water. So I'm gonna dump that in my pot. 1 cup of white sugar. You can also use all sorts of different sweeteners for this. You can use white table sugar. You can use honey. You can use Splenda or Stevia. Or one of my faves is the Turbinado sugar. But I have found that that does create a little bit of a richer simple syrup. So that's really good with like your bourbon cocktails, your tequila cocktails, etc. So with the clear spirited cocktails, I try to stick with the white table sugar. So a cup of that. And then I also have 12 ounces of blackberries washed. These are fresh, but you can also use the frozen blackberries if you'd like. These are on sale and they're in season now, so I figured I'd use the fresh. So this is 12 ounces of blackberries. Don't forget to save a handful for your cocktails for Friday for the garnish. Or you don't have to, totally up to you. I like to eat and drink, so I'm gonna save a few to the side for my garnish for Friday. So in we go. That's it. Super simple. So that's now gonna go on. You're gonna bring it up to a boil, simmer it for probably about, I'd say like 7 minutes until the berries kind of start to break down. And then all you have to do then is kind of let it cool down just a smidge before you throw it in a blender, and then blend it up till it's pretty smooth. However, there will be blackberry seeds in this. So if you don't want the seeds, strain it out. And that way you'll have a really smooth syrup. I will probably strain mine this time just because I haven't in the past. So I figured I'll switch it up and strain it after I'm done with it. So I'm gonna set this off to a side and finish this up. Hey ladies, I see Christy and Stacy. Thanks for joining. So yes, I'm gonna throw this on the stove. Bring this up to a boil, let it simmer for like 7 to 10 minutes or so. Then I'm gonna finish it a little later. So, next thing on our agenda is the basil sea salt for our cocktail rim. This is also super simple. I have a mortar and pestle. If you don't have one of these and you don't wanna buy one, it's totally cool. All you have to have is, you can either use a muddler or you can just use the back of like a large spoon and just kind of like press it down as hard as you can in a bowl. So I'm gonna start with, and I don't really measure this exactly, but probably like a teaspoon of, this is dry basil, and I'm gonna put it in the bottom of my mortar, and I'm just gonna kind of give that a little, squish, I guess. So we're gonna just kind of stir this around. We're gonna be kind of releasing the effervescence of the basil, and we're gonna kind of be grounding it as well so it's not as chunky. So that looks pretty good. It doesn't take long. So then we're gonna add, this is a pink Himalayan sea salt. You can use whatever kind of salt that suits your fancy for cocktails. We're gonna just throw this in there. And then again, we're gonna use the same motion. We're just gonna kind of stir and press down on it to kind of grind it into kind of, not like a powder, but just so it's not super, super coarse. And if you wanna skip this part altogether, no harm done. I just really like a fun rim because it just adds a little oomph to the cocktail. And this is really tasty. And if you have some left over, it's great on vegetables or chicken or fish or anything. So that is done. So I'm just gonna pour it back in one of these and put a little lid on it, and it'll be good to go for Friday. It doesn't look super pretty now, but it will look very attractive on our glass when we are making our cocktail on Friday. Don't forget to set your reminders for 5 p.m. on Friday. I'm back. We're gonna make our first cocktail since I've been on maternity leave from Cocktails with Kirsten. You hear the little baby in the background? Breaking my heart. Anyway, so tune in Friday. I can't wait to see you all. And y'all have a wonderful evening. Bye.